there is one explanation why is that, okay? To put it in your very simple words, when you put your selling price above your, you know, equilibrium line, what would be the situations? Okay, now you draw the line or imagine the situations, what would be the consequences? Okay, market would not be efficient. Okay, so this is the next topic, or this is the another topic that needs to be discussed here. But for now, what you need to have is that, okay, ceiling price means ceiling is above, but the price line, when we draw, in case of the ceiling, should be below the equilibrium. Just have in your mind always, okay, and just for that, okay, and floor price is like, okay, even if the floor is below your feet, when we draw in the graph, it should be always above the equilibrium price, okay? And what is happening now? Let's see the floor price graph here. Now, floor price is the above one, okay? This is P dash, okay? OP is the equilibrium price. Now, OP dash is your price after the government is coming up with the floor price concept. So it's like in the government, they have increased the price, okay? So, okay, now what would be the situations when the equilibrium price, then what is happening now? Draw the perpendicular, draw the dotted line. See, your dotted line, it is just touching the D, and then you can extend this line until it touches your S. So what is happening here? Your supply line is more than that of the demand line. So we can easily say that, okay, supply is more than that of the demand. So in this case, there will be the condition of excess, because supply is more than that of the demand, okay? So this is all about your floor price. And then what would happen then when there is excess in the market? What would happen? Obviously, there will be stock in the producer side, okay? So when there is stock in the producer side, what would government do now? And now government, this stock is simply known as buffer stock here, okay? So this stock, the government will buy the excess product from that producers, and then they distribute it to the other locations where it is needed. And then the other examples also could be like, you know, minimum wages is fixed for the labor to exploit the labor exploitation. Just now, the Prime Minister of Nepal, he has, you know, stated in one speech that, okay, the minimum wages or the minimum salaries would be 15,000. It means that, okay, now if anyone wants to employ any labor for a month, okay, or for a year, he or she has to pay 15,000 minimum. So why would that government fix this minimum wages for the laborers? So imagine that, okay, if there was no any minimum wages fixed from the government side, there would be the labor exploitation. So now someone might be saying that, okay, 8,000 only per month, okay, someone might be saying the 5,000 per month only, someone might be saying 2,000, okay? So there would be the exploitations of the labor. So in order to minimize or in order to avoid those labor exploitations, government is coming up with the strategy of the floor price or the minimum wages or the minimum price. This is not only for commodity, okay? This can be for the labor also, okay? So you should not think that, okay, this floor price and the, you know, this my ceiling price is only for the commodity. No, this can be applicable for the wages also. This can be applicable for the labors also. So this is why the strategies of the ceiling and the floor price from the government is very important. And the next one also could be like, you know, we will do that in the seventh semester, but the taxes is also one price control mechanism. So why would government charge a tax to any commodity? Okay, why are they doing that? Why are government coming up with the taxes? Okay, for the automobiles in Nepal, when you buy a vehicles, okay, you have to pay more than 200% taxes for the government. Okay, so if you buy one motorbike, the same in Nepal, it would cost nearly 3 lakh rupees. Okay, so now when you buy the same motorbike in India, you will get 3 motorbikes there. Okay, so why is that? Because the government has imposed the heavy taxes for automobiles here. Because why would government do that? Because the basic idea for imposing the higher taxes is that, okay, government, they don't want, or they want to discourage the import of those automobiles entering into Nepal. This is one idea, okay? If the government wants to discourage the import of those commodities, then they can come up with the high taxes strategy, okay? This is one strategy, okay? Now, The taxes is a separate topic which we will do in the seventh semesters only. So now, so since we are looking in the equilibrium sides, okay, the, so we have to see from the side of this floor price and the ceiling price also. That's why I have kept the graph here. Now, okay, what happens? What happens when the government is coming up with the floor price concept and the ceiling price concept? What happens to our consumer surplus and what happens to our producer surplus is what we are intending to see here. Okay, this is our main objective here. Okay, now let me show you a graph here. What happens here? So see, initially, let us say initially. Now let me remove this graph. Okay, sorry. Let me remove this line here. Okay, delete. Let me remove this line here. Delete. Okay, let me remove this line here. Delete. Okay, delete this one, and then okay. So. Okay, this is the condition when your market was in equilibrium. Your, you know, the line above this equilibrium line and area below your demand curve is going to be consumer surplus. So it means that the upper region is known as CS and the lower region is known as PS. Okay, so now we are looking into the fact that okay, what happens when government is imposing the price control mechanism. This is the case of, since the equilibrium price is P, and then now we are setting our price below the P. So this is saying that okay, this is saying that okay, our now new price line is below the equilibrium price. It means that this should be of the ceiling price. Okay, so now what happens when ceiling price is imposed by the government? Now let's see. Okay. Control Z. See what is happening. Before, the entire area was your CS and this your PS. Okay, now see what happens. When price is set below your P, P dash is the next line, okay, dotted line. Now, there will be, what will be the area of the CS here? Now, since you are only transacting or since you are only doing the supply of this much amount of your commodity, so there is no any chances that we can go up to this Q. You have no any possibility to go up to there because the supply is only up to Y. So when supply is only up to Y, then what is happening? Before, see my cursor, okay? Before, this all area was your consumer surplus. Okay, now when you are only doing the transaction for this Y amount of commodity, so now you draw one line that just touches your D above, okay? So now there is the formation of a small triangle here, okay? Two triangles can be seen here, the upper triangle and the lower triangle. So collectively we can say that this is one big triangle. So now this big triangle is formed here when the market is not in equilibrium. So this small triangle is known as the deadweight loss here. So we will define what is that deadweight loss, and I do have one examples, practical examples, what is that deadweight loss actually refers to. Okay, I will do that in a minute. But now, so see here, what is happening? Before your, this area, every area was your CS. Now your CS would increase or decrease? What would be the implications on the consumer surplus? Now this would decrease your consumer surplus. Now see, before, follow my cursor, okay? Before this all area was your consumer surplus. Now your consumer surplus would be only this one. This one. So there is the decreasement in the area of the upper small triangle. That upper area of the upper small triangle is lost from the consumer surplus side. Okay, so one might ask questions, okay, where would that go then? I will come there in a minute. Similarly, no, sorry, okay, consumer surplus, it would increase. Okay, I was just confused. Okay, so it's like, you know, consumer surplus would go up to here, down up to here, up to the dotted line. Okay, initially your consumer surplus was only up to this equilibrium point, but now this was also the triangle covered initially, but now after your price line coming below your equilibrium price, your consumer surplus area would be this one, the entire, including this dotted blue line, upper one. This is going to be your consumer surplus line. Consumer surplus. This means that more consumer surplus will be there. So now, if more consumer surplus will be there, what would happen to the producer surplus? Now, initially, your consumer producer surplus was this much amount. And now, since we are only doing the transaction of this much amount of this commodity here right now, so your producer surplus would be only this one. p dash y and coming to the origin and p dash. This area, the small area below, see here, see, follow my cursor, okay? This is your producer surplus. What would be the implications? Your producer surplus will be decreased and your consumer surplus will be increased. But there will be the formation of the two small triangle, and the collectively this two small triangle is known as the dead weight loss. This dead weight loss is known as the welfare loss or the efficiency loss or the loss to the total surplus that would the loss to the social welfare or the loss to the welfare that no one is going to get them. No, even consumers are surplus or the producers is going to get that losses. This is loss for society. Okay, I will come that in a minute. What is that DWS? But for now, just imagine that. Okay, so even if your consumer surplus is increased and your producer surplus is decreased, the total surplus will be decreased. Okay, because this much amount of area is lost because of the DWL. This DWL is known as efficiency loss or the welfare loss in the society forever. I do have one practical example here. I will say that in a minute. What is that DWL? Okay, so see, the area of CS will increase, but PS will decrease. I told you that, okay, this is the area for your consumer surplus. Now, in order to calculate the consumer surplus area, what you need to find out the area of this all entire graphical picture. Then see here, in the downward it is forming the rectangle. Okay, now you calculate the area of the rectangle. Now you may calculate the consumer surplus before at the equilibrium point. You can calculate this and then you may do the reduction of this small triangle area. Then you can get this much amount of the area of the this quadrilateral. Okay, and when you add this one and this one, then your CS will be the entire area. This is how we can calculate the CS. Now it's up to you. Okay, how can you find out the area of that geometrical steps? Okay, you can do in your own way. So in order to calculate for PS, okay, now this is also the formation of the triangle. Now you again use the formula half base into height and calculate the area for the PS, and this is how we can calculate the PS. Now if someone asks you, okay, what is the deadweight loss or what is the societal loss after the implementation of the ceiling price, so what would you do or calculate? How can you do? You have to find out the area for this entire PS and CS, and then do the reduction of this area. Then you get what is the value of CS and PS in that condition, and then, or if you find out this total surplus here before at price P, and then now if you find out this area, follow my cursor, okay, this area, when you do the subtraction, then you would get this smaller triangle area also. So it's up to you, how can you calculate the area for the triangle of that DWL? It's up to you. That really depends on your idea to calculate this mathematical calculations. Okay, so now what happens when ceiling price is being imposed? What is the effect that is bringing to you? It is lowering the price of the commodity now. Okay, since ceiling price is the minimum price, okay, or the maximum price that, you know, sorry, it is the maximum price that anyone has to pay. Okay, the buyers, consumer has to pay to the buyers, to the sellers. Okay, so what it does, it lowers the price. The first implications is it lowers the price. See, before it was P, now it is P dash. It is coming down, it is coming towards the origin. Higher quantity demanded, isn't it? So now when it is coming down, then see here, your demand is more and your supply is less. So in that condition, what happened? When price of the commodity, before it was P and now it is P dash, then more, then that commodity is being, you are able to get that commodity in a cheaper price. So if that is the case, then more consumers are demanding more. Okay, consumers are demanding more of that commodity. So as a result, there will be the high quantity in demand. This is what high quantity in demand. But what happens to the supplier side? So now, before they were getting P, before they were getting more amount of money, but now they are only getting P dash. So what would they do? Yesterday I was getting more, but today after the implementation of ceiling price, okay, I'm getting less. Why would I supply? So there will be the reduction in the supply. Okay, so this results in the lower quantity supplied. So when your demand is more and when your quantity supplied is less, then obviously there will be the you know, formation of the shortage. There will be shortage of the goods. So as a result, what happens? See here, now there will be the more CS. So when your price is down below the equilibrium price, your, you know, area for consumer surplus will be more. Producer consumer surplus will increase. Now, and as a result, your producer surplus, before it was this whole big triangle, downward big triangle, now it is only this one. It is only this one. So it means that the producer surplus is reduced. But okay, due to the market in equilibrium condition, or due to the implementation of the ceiling price by the government side, there will be the losses of the GWEL, and that is GWEL can also be termed as the misallocation of the resources. Okay, and then the inefficiency of the resources or efficiency lost to the society forever, whatever you say, they all are going to be the GWEL. This is what your ceiling price is. Ceiling price is bringing the situation, okay? So ceiling price below your price line. Now, when we move on to the floor price, now this is just reverse to that of the floor ceiling price, okay? Floor price is like, okay, now the price above your equilibrium price. So equilibrium price is, okay, is P here, okay? There should not be any confusion for this interaction between D and S here, okay? Because this is the market equilibrium point, which we have already done it many times. So now, when government is coming up with the strategy of the floor price, what are they doing? The government is setting the price above your equilibrium price. See, let's say equilibrium price for paddy was 50 rupees, but when they come up with the strategy of the floor price, and the price of the commodity would be 60 here. This is what higher than 50 refers to. This is P dash here, okay? So what is the implications to CS and producer surplus here then? Now see here, before the implementation of the floor price, your consumer surplus was all this big triangle, okay? Follow my cursor here. This was your consumer surplus before. Now what would happen when your price is above your equilibrium price? Then now see, this is the only transaction amount that we do. See, demand is only up to this point, okay? So now, before this much amount of area is lost for the consumers, for the consumer surplus, this is lost. This area is lost, and among this area also, this the small triangle above is lost as a deadweight loss. So the net loss to the your consumer surplus would be your rectangle that is being formed here. This is loss to consumer surplus. Now what happens to the producer side? Okay, producer surplus. Now see, before, follow my cursor again. Okay, this was your producer surplus. Now after your floor price implementation by the government, price is above your equilibrium price. Now what would happen? Okay, there. So your producer surplus now would increase. Now it would go up to here. This would be. Follow my cursor. Okay. Again, see, my cursor is in the origin now. So your producer surplus will increase. Now it will go up to this point P dash. It will come up to here, this area, and this line, and this area is going to be your producer surplus. So here, the implication of the, or the impacts or the effects of the price floor by the government side is that, okay, what happens? The commodity price will be higher, okay? And when the price of the commodity is higher, then there will be lower demand of the quantity. When there is lower demand of the quantity and there is a higher supply, okay, because the price that the producer is getting is more now. Before they were only getting 50, now if they are getting 60 rupees as a result of this floor price, then what would they do? They would supply more. So since the supply is more and then the consumers are not demanding more amount, okay, then what would be the consequences? The surplus is the consequences here. So when the surplus is there, then this much amount, follow my cursor here, this is the amount of the surplus. Now as a result of this floor price, what would happen? Your consumer surplus is decreased and your producer surplus is increased. And even if your producer surplus is increased and consumer surplus is decreased, the idea of deadweight loss is also existing here. So here, DWL exists in the condition when your market is not in equilibrium. So you should always expect that deadweight loss should be there. Okay, when market equilibrium is there, no any deadweight loss is there, no any misallocation of the resources, or no any efficiency loss to the society is existing when your market is in equilibrium. When the market is not in equilibrium, Or when the government is coming up with a strategy of the floor price or the ceiling price idea, then you should always expect that, you know, there is the formation of the deadweight loss. That deadweight loss is the triangle, the bigger triangle here. The triangle, this is the smaller triangle and this is the smaller triangle. The area shown to you by the blue arrow here, both of them are your DWL or simply deadweight loss. This is the efficiency lost to the society forever. So now you might be wondering, okay, deadweight loss is that, okay, that is society lost to the, that is the efficiency lost to the society. So what would be the DWL in real practice then? See here. Now see this example that I have given in case of the deadweight loss. Okay. Now imagine that you want to go to Annapurna base camp and you want to go through helicopter. Okay. And a ticket costs rupees. $250. Let's imagine that, okay, the price of the ticket per person is $250 if you want to go to Annapurna base camp and if you want to take the helicopter. And then now you can, you also know that, okay, the value of the trip, it is at $350. If you take the trip, then the value of the trip would be $350, or the benefit that you would reap out of that ride would be $350. Okay. So like, okay, in this situation, the value of the trip is $350 and it is exceeding your real cost of the ticket, that is $250. So here, what would you do? Okay, if you say that, okay, if I go, my value is like, you know, the worth of the trip is $350, okay, I would get the worth or the satisfaction equal to $350 or some monetary. You, someone might be asking, okay, how can we value the trip? Okay, so I really don't have answer to that, but let's say value of the trip would be like $350. So now what would you do? Okay, you would get $100 as a benefit to that. Net value is like, you know, $350, because when you take that trip, you would get the advantage of $350. And you still have to pay the price of the ticket, $250. So the differences between your value or the benefit and the cost is going to be your net value. So $100 is going to be the net value. This is the condition, okay? So at this condition, you would take the ride. Now imagine the situation when the government suddenly decides to impose a tax. So even if we are talking about the ceiling price and floor price concept, the tax is also one strategy that can create the deadweight loss. So I have included the example of the taxes here, okay? Don't get yourself in confusion, okay? We were talking about the floor price and the ceiling price, now coming taxes, why is that? This is also okay. This is also the third important economic tools by the government. So 100% is tax imposed by the government. It means that, okay, now before you were getting $250 per ticket, now you would have to pay $500. So it means that, okay, now you should pay $500 for ticket and then you get only the value of the $350. So now what would be the situation here? Your net value if you take the ride is now, it is going to be how much? Minus $150. Okay, so it's like, consequently, what would you say? You would say that, okay, no, I am not going to take that trip, or now I'm not going to do that trip, because, or there can also happen that there will be the decrease in the demand of the tickets. Okay, so now, before, if the ride was being taken at $250, the government was collecting some sort of tax as a revenue, okay? But now, if no any demand in the tickets is made by the consumers, then now, you know, when your ticket is $500, then if you decide not to travel, then government is losing some sort of revenue because you are not now deciding, you are now deciding not to take a ride. So that loss is referred to as a deadweight loss, and that is lost to the society as a whole, because if you would have taken that trip, then government would have collected some sort of money there. Now, due to the implementation of 100% tax, you decide not to take that trip. So that's why the tax revenue is being lost from the government. And this could be one practical example of your deadweight loss. So if you want to know more on the concept of deadweight loss, okay, but now I already showed you that, okay, deadweight loss, you know, in graphical illustrations in floor price and the ceiling price, and then how can we calculate that deadweight loss also, and what is deadweight loss, and one practical example of deadweight loss, okay. This is what deadweight loss is all about, and then with that note, I am done for this producer surplus and consumer surplus topic. Now, if you do have any questions, then now it's your turn. So you can always consult your online resources, okay, when you want to know more about your some topics, or when you can also go with the Google also, okay, or sorry, with the YouTube also. There are many fantastic videos that really explains what is the concept on DWEL, or what you want to know about the Persistent Plus or Consumer Service. So if you have any confusions, then you can ask me now, and then if I'm not still able to make you understand, or if your confusion is not being is still there, then you can just go with the other resources that is available to you. Okay. Yeah. कि बुझिएन है अलि राम्रोसँग बोल त के भन्नु त फेरि हाम्रो मार्केट रुल अफ थम इज वाट मार्केटको रुल अफ थम के हो त डिमान्ड एन्ड सप्लाई जहिले पनि बराबर हुनै पर्छ द्याट इज द रुल अफ थम है तर कहिले काहीँ के भइदिन्छ भने चाहिँ यो यु नो मार्केट मे नट बी स्टेबल अलवेज मार्केट स्टेबल कहिले हुन्छ त वेन मार्केट इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम देन मार्केट इज इन स्टेबल द्याट इज वाट वी आर लुकिङ फर हामी पनि चाहँदैनौँ कोही पनि चाहँदैन गभर्मेन्ट पनि चाहँदैन चाहिँ डेट वेट लस होस् भन्ने कुरो चाहिँ अथवा सोसाइटीको लस होस् भन्ने कुरा चाहिँ गभर्मेन्ट पनि चाहँदैन तर कहिले काहीँ चाहिँ तिम्रो के हुन्छ भने वेन यर डिमान्ड इज मोर अर वेन यर सप्लाई इज मोर देन देयर इज द एक्जिस्टेन्स अफ द इनइक्विलिब्रियम इन द मार्केट जस्ट लाइक आई गिभ यु एन एक्जाम्पल अफ द प्र्याक्टिकल एक्जाम्पल अफ लेबर वेजको चाहिँ अहिले यसपालिको गभर्मेन्टले चाहिँ साउन 1 गतेदेखि चाहिँ 15,000 रुपियाँ तलब चाहिँ मिनिमम चाहिँ स्यालेरी हुनुपर्छ एउटा लेबरको भनेर भन्दै गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ यदि त्यो मिनिमम स्यालेरी भनेको नै अघि के हो त हाम्रो त्यहाँनिरबाट हेर्दाखेरि फ्लोर प्राइस हो कि सिलिङ प्राइस हो त्यो नाउ यु डिसाइड ओके विच वान इज द्याट मिनिमम प्राइस फिक्स गर्नेको रिजन चाहिँ के हो त द्याट इज वान प्र्याक्टिकल एप्लिकेसन अफ दिस इकोनोमिक कन्सेप्ट बाई द गभर्मेन्ट रिसेन्टली चाहिँ प्राइम मिनिस्टरले गरेको चाहिँ मुभ द्याट इज अल्सो वान इकोनोमिक इम्प्लिकेसन किन त्यस्तो गरेको हो त मैले भनिसकेँ यदि 15,000 रुपियाँ नगरिदिने हो भने लेबरको एक्सप्लोइटेसन हुन्छ कि सो समवन माइट बी कमिङ अप विथ दैट ओके दिस इज दैट ओके म 8,000 मात्र दिन्छु म चाहिँ 10,000 मात्र दिन्छु सो द यु नो द क्यापेसिटी अफ द लेबर माइट बी एक्सप्लोइटेड सो इन अर्डर टु एभोइड दोज एक्स